Hello, my name is Nneka, and I would like to talk to you about how to grow your influence. Influence is a critical component of leadership. And you may be asking, why do I need to grow your influence? Well, you need to grow your influence if you consider yourself a leader in any organization, even at home. A mother who has children is a leader. A father who has children is a leader. So anyone who follows you for any particular reason, or that you are over and have some kind of responsibility towards, somebody's accountable to you, makes you a leader. And influence can be positive or negative, as I'm sure you're aware. You have negative influence of leadership, and a good example is the different terrorist organizations. So for whatever reason, a leader gets followers to engage in you know, just terrible acts of violence. And meanwhile, a positive influence, I can't think of a better example of an influencer as a lady of faith, as a woman of faith, as Jesus Christ. I mean, it's amazing how he's been able to influence millions of followers in over 2,000 years. And so influence is really the power to change or affect someone or something without directly forcing them to do that. And really, how far you're able to influence somebody, or even how long how many people you're able to influence, shows how effective you are as a leader. In fact, John Maxwell, my friend and my mentor, does say that influence is really all about adding value to people. So I would not consider a negative influence to be adding value to people. Well, it's negative value. So it's really about adding value to people. And that's the perspective for which I want to talk to you about ways you can grow your influence. And there are four ways I'm going to talk to you about or share with you. And the first one is about trust. Trust is one of the most important things, building trust in people, and for people to also develop trust in you. So as a business owner, an example will be, do your employees understand the company's values? Is it written down anywhere such that they can begin to align with the values that you have set in the company? Another area that you can increase your influence is enlargement. Growing yourself. Before growing your company, you would need to grow yourself, because really you cannot give what you don't have. And so by you setting goals to grow yourself in whatever area you decide that it's important to you, then you can impact that knowledge that you have with other people. So it's really, sequence is really growing yourself, then growing others, and if you're a business owner, growing your business. Really, there's a limit. There's another law of leadership that I like to talk about, and it's the law of the lead, right? So you really cannot grow. It's like a lead on your leadership. You cannot grow beyond your leadership lead. You just can't. So for you to be able to influence more people, you need to set the objective of actually growing yourself. A third way you can grow your influence is empowerment, and that's empowering people, giving people that are under you responsibility. And this also involves trust, right? Because if you do not trust the people, you can actually empower. So it's not about you doing everything. And I'm looking at the context of a business owner or in the family. You cannot do everything and not create opportunities to delegate responsibilities to those that are under you, because this gives them an opportunity to be empowered, an opportunity to grow. And as a result of that, you're able to now add value to them. And then a fourth way that you can influence others is by having faith in people. Interestingly, I've spoken to a lot of people, and for some reason, either through some experience, some negative experience, are not able to have faith even in the employees, or maybe because the employees have proved, or a lot of employees have proven themselves to not be faithful people. However, there is always the the opportunity to keep trying, right? And but then that also stems from the fact of how well have you communicated your cultural values? How well have you been able to grow the people that are around you? So having faith in people is perhaps one of the most important things around leadership or around influence. And the greatest gift that you can give to someone who you are leading is to be able to express belief in that person, particularly when that person does not believe in their abilities. I mean, there isn't any bigger gift or any greater gift than that, because then you have more or less given that person faith that the person is able to do much more than what the person thinks. And I'm sure you may have been in that position. Can you think of somebody who has been influential in your life, and what were the characteristics of that person? I'd like to hear from you. Perhaps you could share that one particular person that has been very influential in your life. For me, I have to say, I mean, I've had several influencers in mine. Some of my pastors have been very strong influencers, but before then, even my parents, my father has been an extremely strong influencer in my life, as well as my mother. And when I kind of look at these characteristics, trusting, being in positions to enlarge me, so as they grow myself. And then empowerment, I think from an early age, I was given opportunities to be empowered. And so they have more or less influenced my life up until now. So what about you? Who have been the major influences in your life? Of course, I have a list of mentors right now who influence me in different areas of my life. So I'd like to hear from you. Or what other characteristics would you say is needed to be a strong influencer in this decade? I'd like to hear from you. And also any thoughts and comments that you have, also feel free to post them. Until then, ensure you have a successful week. And while doing so, endeavor to live a significant life.